Booker heard.
No, that's the E.
No, that is certainly it.
No, it's not.
If you play the whole song, he'll come back.
Isn't.
Is.
Try again.
No, you try.
Hurry, Booker, hurry! Stop it!
Fine.
Stop it! You don't know what you're doing!
Ha! There it is.
You've done it now. He's coming back. He's coming back.
The notes were correct.
The instrument was not.
One needs both to get his attention.
But if you know how to sing to him...
He will take you where you need to go.
Who are you?
We are... where we are needed.
And needed where we are.
So Comstock uses these songs. Are there others we can use? Something to keep the bird off our back?
Perhaps you should ask the maestro himself.
So where is he? Of course. Well, at least they left the piano.
Booker. That's Comstock House. If we're gonna find him, we should start there.
The box are coming! We need to leave the dock! We need to push off immediately!
Where are these people going?
Wherever the Vox Populi ain't.
Close your eyes! Jump! You can do it! Come on, you can do it! Just jump! Jump! Come on, jump!
I cannot do it! I'm sorry! I love you, but I can't do it. I'm sorry.
You need to remove your belongings or we can't take any more people. The barge is full. You're going to have to remove some of your luggage if we're going to fit more people on deck.
Drive
him out! Get him out of there!
that one.
You bet. Some money. You want it? Okay.
Think you can pick this?
On it.
What is it about that song that brings in the bird?
It always has. When I was younger, I used to be excited when I heard it.
Excited?
He was all I had. He fed me, brought me books. He was my friend.
Friend?
Until I grew up. And I hated him, because he was my warden. He's just Comstock's pet, isn't he? Just like me. All yours. No better than Comstock, was she?
Once people get their blood up, it ain't easy to settle it down again.
This is on our hands, isn't it?
This open?
Keep a lookout. It's done.
Just what the doctor ordered.
There's a lockpick over there.
And innocent alike.
Need money? You don't think anyone can really see the future, do you?
I saw something once when I first got here. A dream. It was New York, but larger than any New York I ever saw. It was burning.
Hope none of the Prophet's magic is rubbing off on you. Sure thing.
Always! You like it by the way!
business, Elizabeth?
Let me see. There you go. At least she invented the technology that allows the city to float.
Giant balloons?
Quantum particles, suspended in space-time at a fixed height.
So, not giant balloons?
But the thing is, my book said they disappeared several years ago.
I told you they'd come.
No, you didn't.
Right. I was going to tell you they'd come.
But you didn't.
But I don't.
Are you sure that's right?
Something tells me they're not exactly what they appear.
I was going to have told you they'd come?
No.
The subjunctive?
That's not the subjunctive.
I don't think the syntax has been invented yet.
It would have had to have been.
Had to have had been. That can't be right.
They seem to want to help.
They seem to be out of their minds.
Odd, isn't it?
What's odd?
The fact that we sometimes...
finish each other's sentences?
Exactly.
It would be odder if we didn't.
How do you suppose they manage that?
I'll get back to you after I figure out the floating city bit. Come on. Comstock House is up ahead.
Prophet shall sit the throne. He was grooming me, wasn't he?
Comstock? Yeah, I think so.
Why lock me up?
Well, I'm guessing you didn't want to be groomed. Maybe he had something in the works to make you agreeable.
Like what?
I think it's best we don't find out.
Some money. Want it?
If there's anyone who could hear,
it's locked.
My voice.
This won't take long at all.
These are dire times, and I could ever
got it.
Use your aid. I hope no one has forgotten me, here. Now back to the music.
sneaking around? Drive,
I'll cut you in half.
Here's some cash. Okay, cash.
Comstock, when we next meet, it won't be to parley. See, I went out to that Hall of Heroes to scalp your false shepherd for you. Turns out, though, DeWitt speaks Sioux. He helped me to swap words with this crippled child I've been, looking after. Now, after hearing how the kid has fared in your city, I'm thinking when we take your pelt, I'll let him hold the knife.
Got it.
another season, another reason for making whoopee. A lot of shoes, a lot of rice. The groom is nervous, he answers twice. It's really kidding that he's so big.
Need a lock picked.
Child's play. All yours.
Thanks. Open it.
On it! So, it's here!
Stop!
That one!
On it!
Go ahead!
On it! Money? Booker, here.
Much obliged. Got a lock here.
Let me have a look. Done.
My quantum atom with waves of light, allowing for safe measurement. Sound familiar, brother? That's because you were measuring precisely the same atom from a neighboring world. We used the universe as a telegraph. Switching the field on or off became dots and dashes. Dreadfully slow. But now you and I could whisper through the wall.
Need some help with this.
Looks easy enough. All done.
Butcher him!
Like hell!
That one! Now!
Done!
She's on the girl!
Perfect timing.
Put it in your brain!
There, that one.
Okay! Those turnstiles are one way. Should we check out the bookstore before we leave? Some cash.
Got it. Think you can pick this?
Let me see. There you go.
Brother, what Comstock failed to understand is that our contraption... a window not into prophecy, but probability. But his money means the Lutece field could become the Lutece tear. A window between worlds. A window through which you and I might finally be together.
Downstairs.
Sally! The bastard snuck in while the Vox was shooting up the place and took my girl! Got her locked up in the salty oyster. His hidden closet, he keeps all his treasures. Just need to hit the button under the register to open it, but...
lock when we pass through. We won't be able to return. It's a simple dual-dial lock. My book said most fools keep the combination no more than 20 feet away.
Let's hope we find one of those fools. This might be it. Why are you so keen on lockpicking and code breaking?
If you put a person in a cage, they develop an interest in such things.
I suppose so.
And I won't be locked up again.
Elizabeth. Elizabeth, you...
Promise me.
I will stop him.
No. That is an oath you cannot keep. But promise me that if it comes to it, you will not let him take me back.
It won't come to that. All right.
Thank you.
Booker? Booker!
Now!
On it! Need this? Sorry, that's all I've got. Still looking. More money? Okay, cash.
Locked. Elizabeth? Back there at the shop, what you asked me to do...
Let's not discuss it.
No, what did that thing do to you?
If he were to take me back... That's death, Mr. DeWitt. Or something so like it, I cannot tell the difference. What a waste. Is the city going to come back from this?
Maybe it shouldn't.
Ready. We need to get to Comstock House, Booker. Let's head back outside.
Can you open this?
Looks simple enough. Got it. I found some money. Want it? Cipher is.
Got a lock here.
Looks easy enough. There you go. Here's some cash.
Better already.
Hmm.
Press to generate a magnetic shield. Hold to absorb damage and release to throw it back. Hold and release to create an explosive trap.
Found some money.
Take a look at this lock.
Seems easy enough. It's done. found some money. Want it? Those pennants. Seems like the Vox have chosen their favorite color.
Seems about right. Wanna take a look at this?
I'll give it a whirl. Got it.
Lockpicked.
Okay. All done.
Thank you.
Go on without me.
Of your finest.
I see him!
This one open?
Let me see. Ready.
and looked at me and said, "Your family tree shelters a teepee or two, doesn't it, son?" This lie! This calumny had followed me all my life! From that day, no man truly called me comrade. It was only when I burnt the teepees with the squaws inside did they take me as one of their own. Only blood can redeem blood.
Now.
Go ahead. I'll be fine.
Do it.
There. Thinking about that dream that you had. New York on fire. There's something about it. Onto this. Beyond that gate lies Comstock House.
Comstock, how lovely to see you. Wonderful of you to make the journey, especially considering your painful death 19 years ago.
Lady Comstock.
The dress. The thing has mistaken me for my mother.
Your fingerprints do not seem to be your own today, Lady Comstock. Are you unwell?
This isn't going to work.
I think it can.
Your mother's dead, Elizabeth.
Yes. I think it's time I paid my respects. Let's head to where she's buried. There's the graveyard where my mother's buried. Albert Fink's house. I love his music. I wonder if he's in there.
What are we looking for?
There it is.
Mother's grave.
They have her preserved in an airtight chamber. Her fingerprints will get us into Comstock House.
She's your mother.
A mother who abandons their child doesn't draw a lot of sympathy in my book.
Take a moment to think about what you're doing.
There. Will you open the door or do I have to go in without you?
Elizabeth.
It's her. How are you, Mother? Locked up in there, huh? Looks like you and I have some common ground.
Let me do it.
No.
Let me do it.
You see, child, you chose to follow a false shepherd, and he has led you astray.
Elizabeth, are you all right?
Where did she go?
Hold on, you need to rest for a minute.
No, I'm getting that hand.
Elizabeth, why is your mother a ghost?
She's not. He used me to power that device. He opened up some kind of air.
Seeing your mother! She's crazy!
What am I? My God. Is she the source of my power?
But what is she? Alive or dead?
Why do you ask what?
When the delicious question is when.
The only difference between past and present
is semantics.
Lives, lived, will live.
Dies, died, will die.
If we could perceive time as it truly was,
what reason would grammar professors have to get out of bed?
Like us all, Lady Comstock exists across time.
She's both alive and dead.
She perceives being both.
She finds this condition disagreeable.
Perception without comprehension.
It's a dangerous combination.
Look! Footsteps!
She goes to unfinished business.
We have to follow her. Convince her to open the gate to Comstock House.
It's a shame you have need of her to enter Comstock House.
Frankly, she doesn't seem all that cooperative.
There is a way to bring her to reason.
Three truths you must discover first.
Truths which, in this world, Comstock has destroyed.
If only one of you had the power to alter time and space.
That would be a blessing, wouldn't it?
Well, they're sarcastic.
There's something off about Lady Comstock.
Yeah. I noticed.
No, you don't understand. She doesn't belong here. I brought something through. I'm not so sure it was her.
Much obliged!
Get out!
I'm in the game!
Lock.
Child's play. Done. something in there. Should I open it?
You whore!
That's my mother.
I assure you, madam, my sexual interest in your dear prophet is non-existent.
And Madame Lutece?
Furthermore, the man is quite sterile. It's a lie. Come here, you little bastard! I want her out of my house!
Childhood they decided to imprison. She deserved whatever Comstock did to her.
Lady Comstock seems to believe the child is a result of some errand.
What did you mean before when you said Lady Comstock didn't belong here?
She's almost feral. It's like she's a reflection. I don't know.
Sterile by simple exposure to our contraption. A theory. Just as sexual reproduction can de-emphasize the traits of each parent, so goes the effect of multiple realities on our own. Your traits dissipate until they become unrecognizable or cease to exist.
Just what the doctor ordered.
Ha!